Hello each and everyone, the one who is watching my video, welcome to Global Online University. Hope all are doing good. In this video, we will see the International Economic Institution, International Monetary Fund, World Bank, United Nations Conference on the Trade and Development, and the World Trade Organization. This is a really important topic from the exam point of view because most of the time you receive the question from this. So do watch this video to clear your doubt about this topic. And one more important thing I want to tell you that every day at 6, I will be uploading my video on the Global Online University. So do visit our channel every day at 6 and do watch my video to clear your exam. Before going ahead, I want to tell you that we the Global Online University brought for you course for the paper 2 commerce for 2022 in which we will be offering you full syllabus notes of all the 10 units with the detailed explanation, full syllabus test series covering 1000 MCQ with the detailed solution, previous year question from 2015 to 2020 with the detailed explanation, full syllabus video lecture with the detailed explanation. If you take this course, then you will also get paper 1 course, that too free of cost, in which we will be providing you 50 mock tests with the detailed explanation, full syllabus notes of all the 10 units with the detailed explanation, video lecture of all the 10 units with the detailed explanation, previous year MCQ and a previous year question PDF will be also provided to you. The fee of course is just rupees 5000, and student, this is the best time to join the course because you will get enough time to crack your exam. To join, please contact on given number and please do WhatsApp message, or you can also download our app Global Online University. Students, new registration has been started, so please hurry up. The last and the most important topic under Commerce Unit number 1, that is International Economic Institution. So frequent changes in the exchange rate introduce considerable uncertainty and make a thing difficult for the smooth conduct of the international trade. Exchange rate should be reasonably stable for the smooth conduct of the international trade. Agar mano exchange rate stable hi nahi hai, to international trade karne mein problem ho sakti hai, kyunki wo smooth function nahi hoga. Okay? And this can be achieved if the country particularly develop the countries cooperate with each other. International cooperation is a basis of the sound international monetary system. So here we will see some of the international economic institutions. The first point here is International Monetary Fund, which we also call IMF. IMF came into the existence on 27 December 1945. Please remember this because most of the time you will receive question on this. IMF setup karne ka jo decision tha was taken at the United Nations Monetary and Financial Conference of 45 country held at the Bretton Woods. Aur iska jo headquarter hai wo hai Washington DC mein, and is governed by and accountable to the government of a country that make up its nearly global membership. IMF established hua tha to promote the health of the world economy, international monetary cooperation, exchange stability and orderly exchange arrangement, to faster economic growth and high level of employment, and to provide the financial assistance to the country to ease the balance of payment adjustment. And currently IMF is having 188 members. Some of the objective which you have to go through is, the first one is to promote the international monetary cooperation. The most important objective of the IMF, that is International Monetary Fund, is to promote the international monetary cooperation. Then is to ensure the exchange rate stability. Yes, this one is the second. Then is to ensure the balanced international trade, and to eliminate or to minimize the exchange restriction by promoting the system of multilateral payment, and also to minimize the imbalance in quote term and duration of international trade. These are the some of the objective of IMF. Okay, you don't have to go in deep, but please understand the concept, because understanding concept will help you to score more marks, because any question you receive on the IMF, you will be able to answer that question. India and IMF, that is International Monetary Fund. इंडिया एक फाउंडर मेंबर है आईएमएफ का, जिसने फंड अग्रीमेंट साइन किया है ऑन 27 दिसंबर 1945 एंड टिल 1970 इंडिया कोटा इन द फंड वाज अ फिफ्थ एंड इट हैड अ पावर टू अपॉइंट अ परमानेंट एग्जीक्यूटिव डायरेक्टर विद द इंक्रीज इन द फंड कोटा आफ्टर द मे 1970 द कोटा ऑफ जापान कैनेडा इटाली increase more than that of the India. Accordingly, India ceased to hold a permanent position as an executive director of the fund. India represented in IMF by the executive director, who also represented Bangladesh, Sri Lanka and Bhutan. Okay. India ek major beneficiary hai fund assistant ka. It has getting the aid from the various fund agency from a time to time and has been regularly replying its debt. India has taken the technical consistency for solving its international economic problem. The group of the expert group of the IMF have visited India on the various occasions. Till here you have to remember that India is one of the founder member of IMF and signed the agreement on 27 December 1945. Okay. Then is the World Bank. The International Bank for Reconstruction and Development, that is IBRD, known popularly as the World Bank, was set up at the same time as the IMF at the United Nations Monetary and Financial Conference held at Bretton Woods in July 1944. Here, please remember the year, that July 1944. Okay. But iska jo actual operation tha, wo start hua in June 1946 mein. It is an international agency owned by the government, which operate by the board of a governor making long-term loan to member country and finance productive investment in member country. The IMF was designed to provide a temporary assistance in correcting balance of the payment difficulty, and institution was also needed in assist the long-term investment purpose. IBRD established for promoting the long-term investment loan on the reasonable term. Iska jo main aim tha, wo tha to promote a long-term investment loan on the reasonable term. The World Bank is an internal governmental institution, corporate in a form, the capital stock of which entirely owned by some member government. The another topic under the World Bank is the World Bank Group, under which just now we talk about the IBRD. The second one is IDA. The full form of IDA is International Development Association. It's one of the largest and most effective platform for fighting the extreme poverty in the world poorest country. ये World Bank का एक part है, जो कि help करता है world 74 poorest country and is the single largest source of a donor fund for a basic social service in this country. उसके बाद है आईएफसी. द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ आईएफसी इज इंटरनेशनल फाइनेंशियल कॉर्पोरेशन. ओके. इट प्रमोट द प्राइवेट सेक्टर इन्वेस्टमेंट बाय सपोर्टिंग हाई रिस्क सेक्टर ऑफ द कंट्री. उसके बाद है मीगा, दैट इज मल्टीलेटरल इन्वेस्टमेंट गारंटी एजेंसी. इट प्रोवाइड द पॉलिटिकल रिस्क इंश्योरेंस टू द इन्वेस्टर एंड द लेंडर इन डेवलपिंग कंट्री। ये पॉलिटिकल रिस्क इंश्योरेंस प्रोवाइड करता है फॉर द इन्वेस्टर एंड द लेंडर। देन इज ICSID, दैट इज इंटरनेशनल सेंटर फॉर सेटलमेंट ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट डिस्प्यूट। इट सेटल द इन्वेस्टमेंट डिस्प्यूट बिटवीन द फॉरेन इन्वेस्टर एंड द होस्ट कंट्री। ओके, दिस आर द डिफरेंट वर्ल्ड बैंक ग्रुप, दैट इज IDA, IFC, MIGA एंड ICSID। देन इज द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ द वर्ल्ड बैंक अंडर विच द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज बोर्ड ऑफ गवर्नर। सो ऑल द पावर, जो कुछ भी पावर है बैंक के, वो बोर्ड ऑफ गवर्नर के हाथ में होते हैं, विच इज द सुप्रीम पॉलिसी मेकिंग बॉडी ऑफ द बैंक। द बोर्ड कंसिस्ट ऑफ अ वन गवर्नर एंड वन अल्टरनेट गवर्नर अपॉइंटेड फॉर द 5 ईयर। जो भी हम गवर्नर अपॉइंट करते हैं और अल्टरनेट गवर्नमेंट अपॉइंट करते हैं, वो 5 ईयर के लिए अपॉइंट होते हैं बाय ईच मेंबर कंट्री। ईच गवर्नर एज द वोटिंग राइट, विच इज द रिलेटेड टू द फाइनेंशियल कंट्रीब्यूशन टू द गवर्नमेंट विच ही रिप्रेजेंट। द बोर्ड ऑफ अ गवर्नर मीट एनुअली टू चेक आउट द जनरल पॉलिसी ऑफ द बैंक। द सेकेंड पॉइंट अंडर विच इज बोर्ड ऑफ एग्जीक्यूटिव डायरेक्टर। सो इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ 21 एग्जीक्यूटिव डायरेक्टर। ऑफ देम 5 मेंबर आर अपॉइंटेड डायरेक्टली बाय द परमानेंट मेंबर कंट्री लाइक अमेरिका, फ्रांस, लंडन, जापान एंड जर्मनी। एंड दिस मेंबर आर अपॉइंटेड फॉर द 2 ईयर। And the rest remaining 16 members are elected by the remaining country, and each executive director hold a voting power in the proportion to the share held by its government. The board of executive director meet regularly once in a month so that they can carry out the routine working on the bank. The third point under this is advisory council. इन्हें बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर अपॉइंट करता है एंड इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ अ 7 मेंबर फ्रॉम द मेंबर कंट्री हु आर अ एक्सपर्ट इन कॉमर्स, इंडस्ट्री, बैंकिंग, एग्रीकल्चर, लेबर, ट्रांसपोर्टेशन एंड लॉ। उसके बाद है लोन कमिटी। दिस कमिटी रिकमेंड अ लोन रिक्वायर्ड बाय द मेंबर कंट्री। ओके, एंड द लास्ट पॉइंट हियर इज प्रेसिडेंट एंड द अदर मेंबर्स ऑफ अ स्टाफ। प्रेसिडेंट जो होता है उसे अपॉइंट करते हैं बोर्ड ऑफ डायरेक्टर एंड ही इज द चीफ एग्जीक्यूटिव ऑफ द बैंक। एंड ये रिस्पॉन्सिबल होता है फॉर द कंडक्ट ऑफ डे टू डे बिजनेस ऑफ द बैंक। सो दिस इज द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ द वर्ल्ड बैंक। यूनाइटेड नेशन कॉन्फ्रेंस ऑन ट्रेड एंड डेवलपमेंट। यूनाइटेड नेशन कॉन्फ्रेंस ऑन ट्रेड एंड डेवलपमेंट इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड एज अ प्रिंसिपल ओरिजिन ऑफ जनरल असेंबली ऑफ द यूनाइटेड नेशन। इट हैज इट्स ओन सब्सिडियरी बॉडी एंड ऑल्सो फुल टाइम सेक्रेटरीट। इट हैज अ परमानेंट ओरिजिन कॉल्ड अ ट्रेड एंड अ डेवलपमेंट बोर्ड एज अ मेन एग्जीक्यूटिव बॉडी। और ये जो है वो साल में 2 बार मिलते हैं। इट कंपोजेस ऑफ 195 member elected by the conference from among its member on the basis of a equitable geographical distribution. Some of the function of United Nations Conference on Trade and Development are: it promote the international trade all over the world between the developed and the developing country with a different social economic system to accelerate the economic development. The second function here is to formulate a principle and a policy on international trade and related problem on economic development, to make a proposal for putting the said principle and the policies into the effect, and to available as a center for a trade related document in the development policy of the government. So this is all about the United Nations Conference on Trade and Development. देर इज वर्ल्ड ट्रेड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन दैट इज WTO, ये एस्टैब्लिश हुआ ऑन 1 जनवरी 1995 को. द वर्ल्ड ट्रेड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज अ इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन दैट एस्टैब्लिश रूल फॉर द इंटरनेशनल ट्रेड थ्रू द सेंसस अमोंग इट्स मेंबर स्टेट. ओके, सो हियर द एनुअल बजट एस्टिमेट एंड द फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट ऑफ WTO are presented by the Director General to the CBFA for a review and a recommendation for the final approval by the General Council. Okay, so here the some of the objective of WTO are to improve the standard of a living of the people in the member country, to ensure the full employment and a bold increase in the effective demand, to enlarge production and trade of good, to enlarge production and trade of services, to ensure the optimum utilization of world resources, to accept the concept of sustainable development, and to protect the environment. Please remember when it established and the basic concept about this. WTO agreement. So under which the first agreement is agriculture agreement. The WTO agreement on the agriculture contain provision in the three broad area of the agriculture and the trade policy, and this three area are the market access, domestic support and export subsidies. The second one here is TRIPS. If you see the full form of a TRIP, that is trade related aspect of intellectual property right, ye aaya tha on 1 January 1945 ko. The area of intellectual property that is a cover are a copyright and related right performance producers of a sound recovery. The third one is TRIMS. The full form of TRIM is trade related investment measure. The agreement on a TRIM of the WTO is based on the belief that there is a strong connection between the trade and the investment. The restrictive measure on the investment are a trade destructing. According to TRIMS, provision country should not adopt the investment measure which restrict and destroy the trade. The objective of TRIMS is to ensure the fair treatment to the investment in all the market in all the member country. As per the TRIMS agreement, the member are required to notify the WTO council for a trade in a good of their existing frame that are inconsistent with the agreement. And last one is GATS, that is General Agreement on Trade in Services. Ye aaya tha on the January 1995 ko as a result of round negotiation. The treaty was created to extend a multilateral trading system to the services sector in the same way the general agreement or a tariff and a trade provision such a system for the merchandise trade. All the member of WTO are a party to the GATS.